Incendi.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
All members speaking hereafter, you have 5 minutes each. So compose your views and give them in 5 minutes.
Mr. Speaker, I also arise to applaud a speech by HE during his national address, which focused on key issues that are affecting actually Kenyans. Mr. Speaker, listening to the president, actually I saw hope in myself, and which I also believe if Kenyans really listened to him, then he was kind of sowing a seed of hope among Kenyans. Mr. Speaker, I know most Kenyans could be going or undergoing some difficult moments because of the various issues affecting them, like SHA, etc., etc. But listening to the President's speech, Mr. Speaker, what he's saying is very promising. And is what was also focusing on, Mr. Speaker, some of the issues we are seeing them really happen, take root in our country. Mr. Speaker, I know that Kenya is very rich in agricultural production. Kenya is very rich in terms of labor. And Mr. Speaker, the President has focused so much on revival of agricultural production. Mr. Speaker, personally, a person who comes from Western, we have been suffering quite a lot. Most of the persons in Western Kenya are very poor. This poverty is arising from the fact that most of us were focusing on production of maize, which was not selling well in the country, and production of sugarcane in the country, whose prices even went low as 2,800 per ton, because most of the factories had actually collapsed. And Mr. Speaker, when you see what the President is now talking about, because when he was visiting even our Western region, which is rich in production of cane, you see, he was giving us hope, telling us about the possibility of reviving these factories. And indeed, when he has become the President, he has revived the 17 factories we are hearing. He has actually signed into law the Sugar Act, which now will ensure, because the 2010 Constitution, Mr. Speaker, killed the Sugar Board, the Sugar Act. And this actually caused a lot of confusion in the sugar production. Most of the farmers did not have any control. And because of this, most of the factories actually went down. And because of also the collapse of Sugar Act, Mr. Speaker, there was massive import of sugar in the country and causing most of our farmers in Western Kenya particularly suffer. But currently now, I can even assure our people in Western Kenya that the future is very good, because even prices now have risen to from 2,800 now per ton to 5,000 shillings per ton, which is promising to us Kenyans. Mr. Speaker, I recall even my days of schooling, we were relying on production of milk, sale of milk to KCC. This collapsed in the 1990s. Mr. Speaker, I want to assure even the Kenyans and the people who are producing milk, particularly in Western Kenya, the President, when you listen to his speech, and indeed what he's doing, his focus in the revival of the new KCC is giving us hope. Even for us in Malaba, for example, I can say, we are actually, the county government had put up a factory for milk production, but we were getting into some headwinds. But we have been assured now with this that with the revival of KCC, with a kind of massive investment in KCC, Mr. Speaker, we are being assured about delivery of coolers in the country, delivery of coolers up to our plant in Malava, and this will ensure that the milk we produce will be actually absorbed and Kenyans will lead a proper, better life, even people of Malava. Mr. Speaker, we know some regions in this country have gone rich just because of one commodity called coffee. Most of us in Western Kenya, we were focusing on so much on maize and sugarcane production, and most of us have been so poor and been wondering why. We learned that coffee is also another cash crop that is good, can do very well in Western Kenya, and the President actually, through his efforts, much is happening on the ground. Most of the farmers are now happy taking to the production of coffee, and I believe farmers with this kind of positive attitude to coffee farming, Mr. Speaker, I believe this country will move steps up, up, up to richness like these other countries that have become rich. And finally, I want to appeal to Kenyans who seem to be so hopeless with Taifa Care that our business is to register. I can give an example to Kenyans and to the persons of Malava. There is this particular mother to a friend of mine called Livingstone Mohati in South Kabaras, who had registered for SHA, and when the mother went to hospital in Eldoret, referral hospital, she incurred a bill of 491,000. This was settled by SHA. So my people of Malava, let us register, as this plea is actually all over and will lead a better life. We'll stop selling our lands, we'll stop selling our cows, we'll stop selling our property because of some elements, because of some.
Thank you, Honorable Malulu. Honorable Member.